So I know that when you started the company 10 years ago, you wanted to put smaller independent restaurants kind of on a level playing field with national chains. How is ChowNow different from competitors like DoorDash and Grubhub?
Sure. So that's exactly right. We wanted to give restaurants control of their brands, their presence, their customer relationship, and that's exactly what we started out 10 years ago doing. It's what we do today. So we offer three amazing products. One is what we call ChowNow Direct. It's a white label platform that allows any restaurant anywhere in the country, regardless of budget or size, to basically have the tools that the big national chains have. So branded mobile apps, membership programs, loyalty programs, customer data. And we offer that for a flat monthly fee. And so we have about 22,000 restaurants now that use that platform. We have two other products that are a little bit newer. One we announced this week, which is the Order Better Network. And so that allows restaurants to basically take orders across some of the largest apps and websites across the internet. So Snapchat, Nextdoor, Google, Yelp, TripAdvisor, the list goes on and on. And that was announced this week. And then we also have the ChowNow app, which is our version of Marketplace that gives restaurants full control where they can avoid paying commissions. And we're seeing growth of the ChowNow app but welcome restaurants control, which is why we're different.
The Order Better Network, how does that fit into ChowNow's growth strategy?
So restaurants over the years have come to us and said, "Hey, we, like every other business, want to grow. It's important to us. Can you help grow our takeout business?" And so what we started to do is we started having conversations with some of these sites and apps out there that have a lot of foot traffic. We liken it to when a restaurant opens up a physical location, whether it's their first location or their 10th location. It has always been the kind of classic location, 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 meaning restaurants want to open up where there's a customer base, right? Whether it's an office park or university or kind of a residential area. It's always about what's this audience that I can tap into and build my customer base. We take that kind of concept and we take it online. And so where is that physical, or sorry, digital foot traffic online? Where are the eyeballs? And so they are on Google Maps, they are on Yelp, they are on TripAdvisor, they are on Snapchat. They're kind of all these places. And so what we created and launched was a very simple platform for any restaurant in the country to use that allows them to take orders off of these sites and apps out there and continue on that theme of control. So they can control their menu prices, the fees, the pay, who pays what, how much they want to charge on all these. But we make it very, very easy, all from one location, one dashboard that controls all of it. And again, that's what we announced this week.
And so you are arguing that your competitors actually hurt restaurants by taking big cuts, big percentages of their orders. How do you get that message out to consumers, or is it more aimed at restaurants to stop using the other apps?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not sure that message comes from us. No doubt that we repeat it, but I think, the media, restaurants, industries, city governments have all been kind of saying the exact same thing for a few years now. I think at this point it's kind of fairly obvious that the way that restaurants feel towards Grubhub and other companies in the space, we are just an alternative. It's what we've always wanted to be. We wanted to be a platform that restaurants wanted to use, that came to us and said, "Hey, we want to use your platform. We want to work with you. We want to partner with you." I'm not sure they feel that way about Grubhub and others. There's a campaign rolling out in New York right now that Grubhub launched about every seamless slice is a Grubhub slice. And the kind of the running joke across the industry, across New York, is they're talking about the slice of commissions that they take from restaurants' revenue. And again, that's not us saying that. That's the industry. That's restaurants and city governments and the media that has put a spotlight on it. We just want to create an alternative, and that's what we've been doing for the last 10 years for independent restaurants across the U.S.
Do you see an IPO for ChowNow in the future?
I think we're probably closer today than we were a few years ago. Not to say that's the only option for us in the future, but it's something that we're considering, and it's obviously not going to happen this year, likely won't happen next year. But the current path and the kind of growth rate and where the business is today, it's an option, and we may pursue it at some point.